Welcome back, one and all, whoever may be watching this. This is Life is Strange Part 9. Now, I'm just going to risk the copyright claim and just talk about the ending of the last video for a hot second because I've had some time to process. This is the first time I've actually been engaged and eager, really eager to play this game. I think up until this point, everything has been pretty obvious. The blurb for the game itself on Steam mentioned that her brother died, so going into this game I knew that was going to happen, so I was just waiting for it at some point. Mac being the obvious villain was quite obvious, and then Alex or Steph being potential love interests was also quite obvious, and then, you know, there's been little things in between with other different characters and stuff, but I would say the more significant parts of this game were, at least to me, quite obvious. I did not pick up at all on Jed being the bad guy, or a bad guy. I don't quite know what his situation is, but we'll find out. So as a result, I'm now kind of like, you've got my attention going into what I'm assuming is the final act of the game. So I'm actually kind of keen to see what happens, you know? We're progressing, we're getting somewhere.
Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I thought I learned what it means to make a place your home.
That must have felt like quite the victory. Let's talk about how it feels to know that you might have been wrong. I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Found some friends you could trust. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
You're wrong. I don't belong in here.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
What the fuck? Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock. Alex Chen? My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure. Huh.
Right, so we're looking for a combination. I was actually kind of expecting her to do some kind of voiceover. Oh, we've got to find some numbers. That's what this game does.
Is that what I look like? Really? These don't belong to Dr. Lin. tuning peg.
In light of all the recent excitement, now is a good time to remind Helping Hands residents that impulses to leave our institution, while understandable, are best resisted. Remember, the outside world is sharp-toothed and possessed of an insatiable hunger, and you are soft and slow and appetizing. Why throw yourself into its mouth? Throw yourself instead into mine. Nice. Oh, look. So many. Interesting. Okay, that was a bit of a fluke, but I'm glad I saw that. Let me just check the tape recorder just in case. Okay, no, just play. Alright, was there anything else here?
That's me.
Hey, 533322. Yep, I'm making connections. Let's go. Oh, hold on, let's open. Diagnosis question mark. Oh, story of my life right there.
Thrown down a what?
Okay. I didn't read all of that, so I hope it wasn't important. Hold on. 533. Your head's in the way. 22. Yes. Probably should have looked at it, maybe. Back to reality. Oh, you know the rest of that song. Alright, isn't she shot as well? Don't tell me the bullet just grazed her, in quotations. Oh, jeez, love. You were so lucky.
Oh.
she would have so much internal bleeding. Maybe a broken spine. All of her ribs would be cracked, at least, if not shattered. The end? 'Cause she should be dead. Oh, okay, we're back here. Great.
Psst. Alex.
Gabe? You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick. So is our father, but it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me.
So I have to add a bit of an asterisk to my intro. I am interested in the Jed side of things. All of this stuff leading up to it is a little bit annoying. But let's do it. Let's get this done. I'm assuming it'll be similar to the last situation.
There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes.
Too right. I'm there with you.
We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school. Mom used to fidget with her keys whenever she was worried.
Gabe, Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today, and I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom, are you okay?
Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while. But I am going to be okay.
She knew. Even then, she knew. It was always too hot in this room.
How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair? There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry. Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex. Go check on your mother.
Okay.
Oh, and we're back.
Wait. Did I miss something?
Apparently you did. Oh, okay. Water. That's new.
No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry.
Oh, maybe I missed all of these.
I spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. It scared me to death.
Okay, just make sure there's nothing else around here. That's all pretty stock standard. Back, Mom. Hello.
Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
Why don't you get her some water? Good. I'm glad that's been added to my inventory.
Thank you. You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? No tears, my strong girl. I want you to make me a promise. Your brother, your father, they are going to need you.
You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex? Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Are we in a TV? Did we somehow jump to Little Nightmares? Is that a VHS slot? Are those VHS tapes? Where are we? What is this magical 90s wonderland? It's Shushu.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both. This is going to suck so bad. Play your part.
There was only ever one thing to do when they got like this. Drown them out and wait for it to pass.
okay. It's just me. But you know that's not how it went down, right?
Can we listen to Dido again, please? Do it. I'm here for it. Oh.
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did.
Okay, I'm just gonna look around for anything that I can actually interact with aside from, you know, looking at.
I can't believe they were ever this happy.
Nice classic rice cooker.
Hey Gabe, I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... that was like, rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school. And my dad, like, he was, helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there. Okay?
So then I wonder if it was Alex who made the call. Can I go? Nope, can't go upstairs. Gotcha.
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We can sell that.
Alex, what is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
If your mother could see you now.
I don't wanna hear about Mom.
Babe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit!
Dad.
Damn it. Alex!
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad! Dad, it's okay. Really, I'm not hurt.
I can't do this.
Dad?
Someone will come. That woman from CPS. Someone.
Dad!
I'm sorry.
No. Dad!
Thank you.
So I guess her life experiences gave her the empathy ability? Oh jeez, we're still doing this. Oh, that's so sad.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You are 12. I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
Play my part.
Okay. Once again, I'm just gonna see if anything's interactable, if that's even a word.
I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
That's bullshit! I don't need it in the fucking rec room! I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms!
Alex, that's enough! Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
Everyone's feelings were so loud. I just needed something to distract me.
Okay, sorry, I wasn't sure if I was supposed to do anything. Nice. I like being watched.
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl. It says here she's sensitive. What does that mean?
why she's never found a home before. I'm sure she's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something
off.
Broken. Wrong.
With her.
Sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich. Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.
No, do not tell me the lamp still works. Nope. I mean, yes, I get it, but no. Okay, I'm just gonna roll with it. If she gets up after that fall, no, okay, I'm just gonna roll with it.
Here.
Just, you know, suspend your belief in reality for the moment, I think, is the only way to approach this portion of the game. And look, I empathize with the situations. I'm not, you know, I've known someone, a couple of people who have died from cancer, and it's a hard situation, and, who have been through foster systems, and it, you know, these definitely aren't situations to take lightly, and I do empathize with that. I think just in the grand total of this game, I'm just a little bit like, let's get on with it, let's keep going. Yeah, we're getting there. I don't know, but anyways, I might leave it here. This may or may not be its own video. I'll find that out, figure it out, whatever. So thank you all for watching, whoever has been, as always, I greatly appreciate it. Please let me know what you think. All of these things are subjective. I'm sure many people out there are loving this game and absolutely vibing with it. But, I have moments. But on that note, I shall see you on the flip side. Bye!
I need to survive.